In this video, we'll see how computers do the four operations. In particular, we'll see how a small CPU faces this task. If you wonder to know how computers add and subtract, or how they multiply or divide, let's see together the adder and the shifter. If you are ready, let's get started. Let's see how we add the numbers in decimal system. We add 637 to 1024. We start with the least significant digit, so from the right. 4 plus 7 equals 11. We exceed base 10, so we write 1 and carry 1. Then we do 2 plus 3 equals 5. But we remember the carry, so 5 plus 1 equals 6. We write 6. Later, 6 plus 0 equals 6. And 1 plus 0 equals 1. So the result is 1661. In binary, the rules are the same, but we have only 1 and zeros. We add the number 7 to the number 11. We start from the least significant bit. 1 plus 1 equals 2, or 10 in binary. So we exceed the base 2, so we write 0 and carry 1. Later we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 because of the carry. And this is equal 3, 1. So we write 1 and 1 is the carry. Later we have 0 plus 1 plus carry 1. Equal 2 or 10, so we write 0 and carry 1. Then we have 1 plus 0 plus carry 1 equal 2 or 10, we write 0 and carry 1. Then we have 0 plus 0 and carry 1, and this is equal to 1, so we write 1 with no carry. Later is always 0 plus 0 equals 0. The result is 18. As we said, you just saw, we have the same rules in binary and the decimal system. In order to build a configuration which adds binary numbers, we need some logic gates. We remember that AND output is 1 only if it has both inputs to 1. OR output is 1 if at least one input is 1, and the XOR gate output is 1 when its inputs are different, so 10 or 01, and it is 0 if its inputs are the same, so 00 or 11. With these gates, we are going to build an adder. Let's focus on adding two bits. These are the possible combinations. We see 1 plus 1 is equal 0, and for the moment we forget the carry. 1 plus 0 is equal 1. 0 plus 1 is equal 1. And 0 plus 0 is equal 0. If we consider this as input A, this as input B, and this as the output, you can identify the XOR working because the output is 1 only when the inputs are different. So we use the XOR gate to add two bits. But we have something more. If we add 1 plus 1, we have 2. So 0 plus carry. So the carry occurs only when both inputs are to 1. For this aim, an AND gate is perfect. This configuration is called half adder. Half adder is not enough because it doesn't take into consideration the carry in. The general bit addition has to add two digits and the carry in. Let's see this example. 1 plus 1 plus 1 carry in equal to 1 plus 1 carry out. Let's decompose this sum. We can sum first the two digits, 1 plus 1, and then the result with the carry in. We can see the first part of the operation is accomplished by the half adder. Let's see the second part. First, we consider the query in, and second, the result of the previous sum. The total result is 1 plus 1 carry out. This is an operation we can perform with another half adder, in which we add the result of the first sum with the carry in. Carry out remains to be considered. It cannot be summed to the other digits because it is a more significant bit. So, whether carry out is formed on the first sum or on the second one, we have to take it out, and we do this with an OR gate. This configuration is called full adder. We can put it in a box to handle it better. Starting from a full adder, we can build a 8-bit adder. We have to sum bit A0 with bit B0, A1 with B1, and so on. We need 8 full adders, in which the carry-in of the previous full adder is the carry-out of the next full adder. So in the end, we have just a carry-in and a carry-out. In this example, we add the number 3 to the number 4, and we obtain the number 7. In this other example, we sum 0 plus 0, but we leave the carry-in to 1, so the output is 1. Please note that leaving carry-in at 1 is equivalent at summing 1 to the input numbers. Now we have an 8-bit adder, and we need a subtractor. Let's see an easy example. 7 minus 4 equals 3. I can write this in the form of 7 plus minus 4. So, if I find a way to represent minus 4 in binary, I have just to add the two numbers, the number 7 and the number minus 4. I can use the adder we have just built. So the problem is how to find minus 4 starting from plus 4. Let's see how to handle negative numbers in binary system. We see an example with 4 bits. We can manage 16 combinations, but in order to handle negative numbers, we have to sacrifice a bit and dedicate it to the sign. Let's choose the first bit, the most significant one. If the first bit is 0, the number is positive. If it is 1, the number is negative. So now we can reorganize our system in this way. First, the negative numbers. And secondly, the positive ones. Now we have to find a smart way to assign the values to our negative numbers. A way which allows us to pass easily from plus 4 to minus 4, so a way to find easily the complement of a number. This way is called second complement. It was proposed by von Neumann in 45. Let's start from the first complement. First complement of a number, for example of 2, is the number which added to 2 gives a number with all bit to 1, or generalizing gives 2 at the power of n minus 1, where n is the number of bits, in our case 4. It is easy to see we can calculate this first complement inverting all zeros with 1s and all 1s with zeros. Now we arrive to the second complement. The second complement of a number, for example 2, is the number which summed to 2 gives 2 at the power of n. So, it is the first complement plus 1. So, in order to calculate the second complement of a number, I must invert the number bits and add 1. Let's see an example. Our positive numbers start with 0 and they arrive to 7. Let's calculate, for example, minus 4. So we start from plus 4, and first we must invert, and second we must add 1. In this way we have found our minus 4. This is the way we represent negative numbers in binary. There are other ways, but in this way we can handle negative numbers easily and execute subtraction easily. So now I can do a subtraction in binary, adding 7 to minus 4. I obtain minus 4, taking 4, inverting it, and adding 1. So now I have to sum 7, or 0, 1, 1, 1, plus minus 4, or 1, 1, 0, 0. And this is equal to 0, 0, 1, 1, which is 3, plus a carry out in the most significant bit, which we leave out. We have this carry out by definition of second complement. We have just to leave it out. This is how a simple CPU can subtract using an adder. We have 8 full adders, which have inputs A directly connected with the first byte and inputs B connected through XOR to the second byte. If I want subtract, I put 1 on the line SUB. XOR with an input at 1 inverts the bit of the other input. Now I have to add 1, and this is obtained putting at 1 the carry in of the least significant bit. Note that if we put SUB line to 0, the XOR doesn't change the bit of the other input, and the carry in is 0, so the configuration performs an addition this time. Finally, note that this XOR puts the carry out to 0 in case of subtraction, where the carry out is always at 1 but with repeat, and it is transparent for the carry out of the adder in case of addition, where the carry is meaningful. This is an example with the help of a simulator. The A byte is 4 and the B byte is 1. If we leave at 1 the selector in the bottom, the system acts as subtractor. Then we have 3 on the output. If we change the selector to 0, it acts as adder, and we have 5 on the output. For the multiplication in binary, we use the same rules we use on the decimal system. In the decimal example, I start multiplying 2 times 3 and 2 times 1, obtaining 26, then 1 times 3 and 1 times 1, obtaining 13, but shifted of one position. Then I add the two numbers, getting 156. In binary is the same, and the times table is quite simple. 0 times 1 is 0, and 1 times 1 is 1. Applying the rules we know, we see when the multiplicand bit is 0, we have only 0, and when the multiplicand bit is 1, we shift the multiplier as many steps on the left as the position of the ones in the multiplicand. In our case, for the first 1, 3 steps, and for the second, 4 steps. Then I add the two shifted numbers, getting the final result. So, a simple and small CPU can multiply numbers with a left shifter and an adder. We see here how easy the shifter is. It is enough to connect the first output of the first register with the second input of the second register, the second output with the third input, and so on. Of course, for the multiplication, we need some logic for detecting the ones and their positions in the multiplicand, in order to know how many steps we have to left shift. And we need also some registers to store the intermediate results. For For the division, things are even more complicated, but I show you a basic way to divide with left shifter and subtraction. We consider a 4-bit example, so n is equal 4. We have just to left shift the divisor from 3 to 0 steps, and in each step we check if the shifted divisor is larger than the dividend. In this case we put 0 as quotient, else we put a 1 as quotient, and we subtract the shifted number from the dividend, updating the dividend. Let's see step by step. We have to divide 15 by 3 in binary. First, we left shift by 3 steps. N equal 3. And we see this number is larger than the dividend, so we put a 0 on the quotient. Second, we go with N equal 2. So, left shift by 2 steps. And we see now the shifted number is less than the dividend, so we put a 1 on the quotient, and we subtract this number from the dividend. Third, we go with n equal 1, and we get a larger number, so we put a 0 on the quotient. Eventually, we consider n equal 0, so no shift, and the numbers are equal, so we put another 1 on the quotient. We obtain 0101, so 5, which is the right answer. This is an elementary algorithm which can be executed with shifter, adder and some logic, but of course it needs some iteration. For this reason, in small CPU, divisions are slow. Modern CPU have some dedicated logic to perform multiplications and divisions, and their ALU is quite sophisticated, but a simpler CPU can add, subtract, multiply and divide just with shifter and adder. Of course, it needs some iterations and some cycles, so we ask something more to the software when our hardware is poor. For example, when a compiler sees a division in the code, it has to start a cycle with several instructions in order to perform the division. Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put that thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.